please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
Let's talk about the issues that are persistent in the IT sector. Reports suggest that the U.S. Department of Homeland Security is readying a proposal that will make getting H-1B visas more difficult. We have some participants from the sector joining us. Sameer Bendre, the Chief People Officer at Persistent Systems. Sudeen Apte, the CEO and Research Director at Offshore Insights, also joins in. Gentlemen, thanks for taking the time out and speaking to CNBC TV18. Sudeen, I want to start off with you because, the margins for some of these technology companies could come under severe pressure if they decide to raise the salary levels for some of their on-site staff in order to make that quota, for the H-1B visas. Is that a big concern now?
Yeah, there are both concerns, actually. There would be concern on margin because of expected salary levels, especially for the lower pyramid, where currently it's $60,000 to $75,000, which is expected to go roughly to $110,000 to $130,000 based on where the exact, the new bill comes in. But however, I think the bigger issue would be the growth also, because as the clients get a little nervous about availability of resources because of unpredictability of H-1B issuance, and to make the matter complex, now it's a little speculative, but now the reports are suggesting that it's not only about the new H-1B issuance, but it's also for the renewals. So if renewals also get into trouble, then the predictability of the resource on field takes a substantial hit, and then clients have already started thinking about how they mitigate that risk of, unavailability of people. So I think, it's a sort of a, it will impact both margin as well as the growth numbers.
Mr. Bendre, good morning and thanks for joining. What we also picked up is that it's possible that the H-4 visas will be stopped altogether, in which case spouses will not be able to work. Is that an additional problem in terms of therefore retaining people offshore?
I don't see H-4 visa too much as an additional problem because that was very limited to a very small group of people who were already H-1 and who had their green card approved. I think the larger problem is the changes which are likely to be happening in the whole H-1B and the difficulties in renewal of the H-1Bs.
So okay. What exactly have you heard in terms of the number of H-1B visas that will be allotted or even problems for those that are already allotted?
I don't think we have really heard anything new from what we have been hearing from all the news which has been coming in from the U.S. The real changes will be what we are seeing is that the number of what we call requests for evidence has increased. So people need to be better prepared for every visa which they are filing. The renewals are taking longer than they should. I think that's where the real challenges lie. Otherwise, I don't think really anything new or major has come up. Okay. So what has come up is something which we have all heard, saying that the rules are going to be tighter, and I think the industry is prepared for that.
Okay. So Mr. Bendre, good morning. So you're saying that as of now, there's no need to make a provision for higher costs and, alter your sort of guidances and your margin outlooks?
So at least I can talk for Persistent. I don't think we really have been as much concerned about this because if I look at what we were paying our employees and we continue to pay, I think we are pretty much in the right bracket there. So it should not be a challenge. Yes, the cost will go up. To some extent, the cost of new visa applications will go up. So those challenges will be there. But as an industry, we are geared up for this. So I believe the bigger challenges would come from how to really come from the ease of doing business. Because if you're not sure of an H-1 extension, how the customer will be affected and how you deal with those challenges. That will be the bigger challenge.
So, Sudeen, we heard other IT companies genuinely worried about the uncertainty. What next from the US is what is worrying them. If they know that this is the cost or this is the number of people, they say that at least we can plan for that. How are you assessing the picture? Can things get much tighter? Right. Because on the other hand, the argument is that there are not enough people of similar skills in the US.
Yeah. You know, let's not get into that philosophical debate about a value of offshore resources and resources from companies like Infosys, TCS, Wipro, etc. And are there people available onshore? So that's, I think, a little bit of a now academic discussion, because what's happening is not in line with the real demand or what clients are looking for. So I'm going to park that topic. To your point on uncertainty, absolutely. I think, you know, there are two ways to look at. One way, this is not new. You know, protectionism, whether it's in UK via TUPE or via H1-B and other visa regulations in the United States, we have seen last year in or early this year in 2017 in Australia. So protectionism is actually growing everywhere, and because of especially unemployment and economic pressures on those regions. So in a way, one can say that this is nothing unexpected for Indian IT, and they have been preparing. Point one. Point two of the same argument is, you know, the type of work which is coming Indian companies' way, you know, more transformational, more digital, actually calls for lot more senior people onshore for transformational work, for modernization work, for integration and business process related work. So really, this is not new, and this was expected even from business profile perspective as well. However, I think what really worries industry, and you know, I've been talking to several large as well as mid-sized companies, is uncertainty and lack of clarity, and possibly there is a lot of speculation also in terms of how and what exactly it will pan out. And you know, what type of a number of visas will be issued, how long it will take. You know, we are not talking about renewal even 2 months ago. Now we are talking about H1B renewals also, H4 visas. You know, from employer perspective, one can always shrug off saying H4 is not important, and you know, we are not really caring, and it's a small percentage. But the people who are going to US and taking those decisions to shift from India to US, for them that H4 is very important, because if the spouse starts working, the economics work very differently. So when people take the decision, those things are very important. So I think uncertainty is an issue. The reason why industry is little concerned, though it was expected, is basically the transformation of delivery models, you know, from India-centric or India-heavy-centric to more globally distributed, to create centers in the United States, to build a sizable base in, you know, tens of thousands, especially for large 4 or 5 companies, actually takes longer time than, what one would think of. So really, that a lack of preparedness on onshore basis versus the delays and uncertainty on H1B or in general visa policies is what actually a bigger concern to industry than actually it hitting a particular financials.
Yeah, that point is taken. Sameer, I just wanted you to come in on this discussion, because you know, what is more beneficial cost wise for a company, raising the salary levels to get a higher share of the H1B quota or just hiring locally?
No, I think so. It will be about the same, because when you look at, especially if I look at persistent, where we already have development centers right across the US, completely both from the East Coast, West Coast, as well as in the middle region, and a lot of concentrations in the Bay Area. The salary levels for a person who is acquired locally and a person who is sort of sent from India, the margin levels are not really too much different. What Suthi spoke about, and I think that's very important, is the uncertainty which we are all seeing. Really don't know what is going to change, how do you plan for it, and especially from an employee perspective. Because if the employee is not sure whether he is going to get an extension or whether he should stay, how he should plan. And ultimately, an employee's uncertainty does affect his output and what he can give. So we need to really be worried about what the employee is going to feel, how he's going to manage his own changes suddenly. Because if suddenly someone says your H1 extension is rejected, how does that person do? Because he or she has to come back to India within a week, which is a very, very difficult thing for an individual.
All right. So, gentlemen, thanks a lot for your time today. Yes, there are, of course, the human issue as well.